The livelihoods of 6.5 billion people are sustained by ecosystems containing almost 2 million known species. The welfare of humankind is utterly dependent on this web of life. Crops and animals feed us. Forests regulate water supplies and provide fuel. Oceans provide food and help regulate climate. And biodiversity is a source of cultural and spiritual wealth for indigenous people and city people alike. Yet only a fraction of life on Earth has been discovered, less than 10%. There could be up to 90 million unknown species on the planet. But all this life is disappearing, and at an alarming rate. According to the Global Biodiversity Outlook, 130 species become extinct each day. That's over 1,000 times higher than the natural extinction rate. Faced by these frightening rates of biodiversity loss, future generations may well have nothing left but video clips to remind them of long-dead species. Projected trends show accelerating species extinctions and loss of habitat throughout the 21st century. Alarmed at this assault on nature, the United Nations has declared 2010 the International Year of Biodiversity.
Our lives depend on biological diversity. Species and ecosystems are disappearing at an unsustainable rate. We humans are the cause. The consequences for economies and people will be profound.
12% of birds are threatened with extinction, 21% of mammals, 28% of reptiles, 30% of amphibians, 35% of invertebrates, 37% of freshwater fish, and 70% of plants. Habitat loss, such as deforestation, is the single biggest pressure on biodiversity worldwide. Conversion of forest to palm oil production, for example, leads to the loss of over 3/4 of bird and butterfly species alone. Invasive species, mostly introduced by humans, are responsible for 40% of all animal extinctions, for which the cause is known. Pollution from farms, from pesticides and fertilizer runoff, is causing dead zones in lakes and seas. Over 200 were reported in 2006. Unsustainable use has led to 3/4 of the world's fishing grounds to be fully exploited or overexploited. For many endangered species, a changing climate might be the tipping point.
Climate change has emerged recently as one of the most important threats to biodiversity. Experts predict that before the end of the century, more than 30% of all known species, plants and animals, may disappear just owing to climate change.
And whole ecosystems in which species live are under threat too. Already 1/4 of the Earth's land area is undergoing degradation. Half the world's wetlands have been drained, and some scientists predict that ocean acidification and rising temperatures could devastate marine life, including the total loss of our coral reefs by 2050.
Nature works as a system, and therefore when you begin to take parts of the system out, if you remove certain species, you do not know whether you have certain impacts on that ecosystem.
It is our life support. It's the source of food, water, medicine, the clothes we wear, and of course, an awful lot of spiritual comfort.
The United Nations General Assembly has declared 2010 the International Year of Biodiversity. This is our chance to inject a new resolve into safeguarding and repairing our life support system. And not just for its beauty and wonder. Across the world, there are countless examples of where the value of biodiversity, the species and the ecosystems in which they live, benefit us all. Biodiversity is at the heart of the world's second biggest industry, tourism, generating $944 billion a year. Biodiversity inspires scientists too. The lotus leaf has a structure so fine it repels almost any liquid. The principle is being adapted to coating ship hulls to increase speed. In Indonesia, protected mangroves and trees form a barrier to cyclones. Watersheds that keep their forest cover, such as here in Costa Rica, or here in New York State, keep clean water flowing to the cities and farms. And protected areas full of life also function to minimize climate change. Forests alone account for 15% of the world's carbon stock.
Safeguarding nature promotes synergies that generate multiple global benefits. Saving species creates jobs, protects people, and boosts local economies. It is a cost-efficient way to address a lot of problems all at the same time.
In Nagoya, a new international regime on access and benefit sharing of genetic resources will make a major contribution to achieving the Millennium Development Goals through alleviating poverty. Parks and wild spaces can transform urban areas from one of the biggest threats to biodiversity to one of the most significant solutions, both for species and for human well-being. The spiritual and cultural value of biodiversity is at the heart of many human societies. And inspired by biodiversity, children in over 50 countries are taking part in the Greenway tree planting program. The planet's natural resources, its biodiversity, provides our wealth, our health, our food and fuel. If future generations have only video recordings of long dead species and vanished habitats, then all our livelihoods, our very existence, is put in peril. The time to act is now. The Convention on Biological Diversity has a crucial role in helping build a global alliance and must be ratified by all the world's governments.
For this International Year of Biodiversity, it's profound.
12% of birds are threatened with extinction. 21% of mammals. 28% of reptiles. 30% of amphibians. 35% of invertebrates. 37% of freshwater fish. And 70% of plants. Habitat loss, such as deforestation, is the single biggest pressure on biodiversity worldwide. Conversion of forest to palm oil production, for example, leads to the loss of over three quarters of bird and...
I call on every country and each citizen of our planet to join together in a global alliance to protect life on Earth. Biodiversity is life. Biodiversity is our life.